Hey everybody, good morning.
We're live.
That's so funny.
We're about to go on the air.
I said, people who take care of chickens are literally chicken tenders.
Oh.
That's funny.
That is funny.
That's funny. Oh, that's good stuff right there, man. Yeah. That's good stuff right there. Can I get a witness? What? Yeah. What?
Man, today
yeah,
is
what,
awesome. Today's gonna be good. We are talking names of Jesus today, and it's a new series, and we cannot wait. We cannot wait.
Whoa.
We've been looking forward to this one. Brandon dropped this one on us last week. It's been so
tease.
Good. Huh?
Don't use that tease.
Okay.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And good Monday morning, everybody out there in Washington, Greenville, and New.
This is Corey here with the Beyond Limits Morning Crew, along with Joel, Jared, and Paul.
Woo, come
happy
on.
To have you back, Joel.
Thank you, thank you.
Dude,
glad
you look
be
good
back.
Behind that soundboard.
Thank you.
Yep. With that golden tan.
I like it.
How was your cruise, buddy?
It was a lot of fun.
Good deal, man.
Vacation.
Awesome, man. We're so happy to have you back, man. Currently 57 degrees outside, looking a little cloudy, but that's all right because it's warm in here. I'm telling you, man. Dude, how was everybody's weekend? I understand we went and saw a particular movie that we can't say
that we
much
can't
about.
Even
we
talk
can't.
About.
We can't talk about it.
No, we can't talk about
it. Makes my heart sad.
My wife warned me. She said, listen, we're going to go see this movie, but you can under no circumstance talk about it on the radio or the live stream.
I feel there's people right now with their fingers on the dial.
Yeah, like, don't do it.
Yeah,
we
like
will not.
Yeah.
We
yeah.
will not.
It's yeah. a bit, it's a bigger and bigger thing problem. You know what I mean? Like people are really spoilers for movies are only getting worse, and people are even more cautious about them as time goes on.
Dude, you know what happened? You know what happened to me?
No.
The guy sitting next to me, it was him and his wife or girlfriend. My man.
In the movie?
Yep, during the movie.
Yep.
The girl had not seen any of the Marvel movies.
Right. Yeah.
Oh,
so man. The man thinks that it is his God-given duty to explain every scene to her and tell her what he thinks is getting ready to happen before it happens. So I watched almost the entire movie with a finger in my left ear so I wouldn't hear what he was saying.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, my goodness.
Yeah, you should probably go see that again for a better experience.
Yeah, I will most definitely go see that again. So today is Monday. Mondays are our devotion day.
Yes.
And Mondays are also a great day for us to pray with you. So what can we pray with you for today? You can hop on the live stream, search Your Daily Show, or you can find it on the 98.3 The Bridge Facebook page. Or you can text us 252-495-0024 with that prayer request. We would love to pray with you today.
Yes, we would.
Yeah, you said, Corey said that he would definitely go see this, see the movie again.
Yeah.
Corey, we went together. He sat to my left, and I think he very briefly experienced what it was like to carry kids, to have kids.
Well, you know, I've been around your kids before, so it wasn't like, at no point did I feel like I was not enjoying the movie. It was pretty fun. That actually added to it.
Yeah.
Every now and then, it was, I'd hear this little, like, to my left, and it was Easton or Noah, mostly Easton, and he was just like, hey, who is that? What's about to happen? And I'm just like, I don't know, just watch. You know?
Corey was sitting in between us, and he knows it's a 3-hour movie.
Yeah, it's long.
I told him, I said, hey, listen, we're going to the bathroom at the last preview. At the last preview, we're going to the bathroom, and we did. I said, don't ask me to go to the bathroom during this movie. It's 3 hours. I know you can hold it. 1 hour in. Psst, Dad. Psst, Dad. And I had to reach across Corey and say, we're not going to the bathroom.
Oh, yeah.
And he goes,
you know that was going to happen. The kid says he ain't got to go, and then he's got
to
go.
Immediately had to go. And then I went and, if you're on the live stream, you know what you're looking at right now. I went and hung out on the bottom rack of an oven for 450 degrees because it looks like I've stood on the face of the sun for whatever reason.
Yeah.
Bright red. But, hey, what a weekend. What
yeah,
a wonderful weekend.
Indeed.
Awesome weekend.
It was. We love it.
It's going to be good. The devotion, we're starting a new series today.
Yes, in Jesus' name.
I love this.
Jesus' name.
I love this because I was reading it, and I was just like, wow, there's power in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
And I love it when somebody puts words on paper
yeah.
for us to bring to other people.
Yeah.
And we can help them understand.
J-O-D, man.
Oh, yeah, man. He delivers all the time.
The Jesus-loving Dennis Woo, really came through with this one. I'm looking forward to it. Don't y'all go anywhere. But right now, when mercy found me. Rhett Walker.
Love some Rhett Walker.
We're only supposed to say the name on the end of the second hour, but if it's up there, a lot of times we'll say.
That's a true story.
Yeah, to just put the intro Tom up there.
Yeah, that's fine.
That would help, wouldn't it?
Uh-huh.
So then you know how long.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that's a true story. We were at the movie theater.
Yeah.
Corey was sitting to my left, and my kids want to sit next to Corey. When we go to before Corey walked into the theater, they were like, "Hey, can we sit? I want to sit." Like they were
Who's
fighting.
Sitting by Corey?
They were fighting to see. Now I got two kids, and there's two seats obviously on either side of Corey.
Uh huh.
But then it became a three-person fight because I was like, "No, I'm sitting beside Corey." So we're fighting before Corey gets there, and I guess who was right beside you, Noah? Or Easton?
Noah at first, and then Easton came and sat on the other side because they went to the bathroom, and then, like, the flood of people came in.
Yes.
And there were people. The only problem with the way that theater is set up, like, there's a lot of theaters now they do pre-signed seating.
Yeah.
We
have pre-signed seating.
Well, this one didn't. We went to the Grand. Still great because they were the only ones that weren't sold out. So... The only problem with that is, though, everybody's buying a ticket, and you might have these odd-numbered families or odd-numbered groups come in. So you've got two seats that are separating two groups, but then you get, like, a family of three walk in, and they need three seats, but there are only two. So that was the kind of issues we were running in. Like, these people came up while they were going to the bathroom, and they literally had to sit right on top of us because I was like, no, somebody's sitting here, which was Paul's seat, and then his kids on the other side of me, but there were two seats right there. So you know how you always try to give yourself that one seat of space if you can? Well, that won't going to happen.
Nah.
No. Somebody was going to sit next to you.
Yeah.
Did we go Friday?
It pretty
night?
Much
Friday
was. Night. Like, if you want to get... It is, even technically. Like, they started showing that movie midnight. And, like, didn't they have, like, a 2:40?
Midnight Wednesday.
Was it Wednesday?
So going into Thursday morning.
Okay, never mind. I thought it was Thursday. Well, then, so we really kind of didn't.
But that is like true opening night.
Yeah. Friday. Huh? Friday, yeah. I went Friday with him after work.
We went Saturday.
Yeah.
And we're sitting there. So we have assigned seats. We walk in the theater and we get up to our seats. And there's, like what you were saying, there's a family of three sitting in our seats.
Yeah.
And so the dad looks at me and he goes, we were H1 and H2. And the dad looks at me and says, are you H3 and 4?
Yeah.
And we were like, no, we're H1 and 2.
Yeah.
He said, and the mom's like, well, we're H1 and 2. And I said, okay, you know. So she pulls out her ticket stub and she was H1 and 2. And I'm like, and she was like, well, let's just go figure out. Like, they double sold it. Let's see if they got any other seats. I said, okay. So we walk up there and they ended up having H1 and H2. For the next day.
Yeah.
Oh, that's horrible.
Yeah. So they were cool and they left and the dad was just like, he said, thank you so much because I've worked all day and I rushed over here and now I'm gonna go home and sleep. Thank you.
Yeah.
So
that's very cool.
So they had to come back and watch it on.
What's
Sunday.
Up? Good morning, Terry Mosley, Norman Kirk, Corey Forlaw, Brandon Nicholson. Great devotion today, man.
Thank you, Brandon.
Donna Phipps Crabtree, good morning to you. Carrie Nicholson, all these folks tuning in this morning. Rudy Oxendine, Danny Bunting. Goodness gracious.
Let's go.
A lot of names, but we love it.
Yes.
Jared Mosley.
Hey.
Hey, right. I got upward there, and I'm done. I'm done.
You got upward?
Yep.
Okay. I'll get the rest of the man.
Cool. Yes. So Corey sat in between me and my kids, and that was a true story if you were listening on the radio. I told Easton and Noah, I said, listen, this is a three-hour movie, Avengers. We're not going to do any, we would never do spoilers up here because we understand. Hey, we froze a little bit. What's up, guys?
Did we freeze on live stream
or something? No, when we freeze, it's just the video portion. They still hear us. It happens every now and then. So, zero spoilers. Don't worry about that. We're not those kind of people. We don't want y'all to be clicking off because you think. So, we're not going to spoil anything.
Yeah, no.
But it's 3 hours. It's a long movie.
Yep.
And I tell my kids, I was like, listen, go to the bathroom now. Because I know their bladders. I know how they can make it to Atlantic Beach and back and not have to go to the bathroom. So I know we were good for 3 hours. So they go to the bathroom at the very last preview. And we come in and we sit back down and Corey is
fighting somebody to keep them out of our seat because as soon as we left, they were like, are these seats taken? And I was like, I felt so bad leaving you there because I knew that was going to happen.
Well, it wasn't that bad. They were very polite, and they understood, like, you know, some people, I feel like they're going to try to haggle with you, but I don't see anybody sitting there. But Paul had his seat to my right. Easton was originally sitting on the other side of that seat, but there were two seats right there on the end, so I was like, well, now Easton and Noah are just going to need to sit together because they're not going to – you want to separate the group and split them, you know. So I was like, yeah, there's a seat here. So they took it. People can be rude about that, but I didn't experience that, thankfully, in that theater that night.
Did that 3 hours feel like it would have gone fast?
Yeah.
Like
for me, yes.
Yeah, it did. It was a long movie, but at no point did I feel like I was bored.
Like you're just ready.
The entire time you feel like you're getting your money's worth.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like there's, you know, like I said, no spoilers. I'll simply say it was an amazing movie.
Best movie I've ever seen.
It really was.
It wasn't the best movie I've ever seen, but it was really good.
That's counting the documentary Top Gun.
Yeah.
So like, I'm on my phone because I have to share from my phone.
Hello, Steve. That you can say it twice.
If anybody else is on the live stream, did you see Avengers Endgame?
Night.
Shoot. 7. 7 o'clock. And we did not walk out of there till after 10.
Yeah.
See, typically, when it comes to movies, like, the runtime is the runtime. That's previews and credits. But we...
I'm having a hard time. Did that take a long time to get
We didn't watch. We didn't stay because... Oh, yeah, we didn't stay for the after credits. We just...
Like, find them on YouTube.
Yeah. Like, we went ahead and left. But even still, it was still after 10.
I see what Corey's doing, and it's awesome.
Yeah. It was still... we still left one there after 10.
Yeah.
3 hours long.
All right.
It was a long time.
Yeah.
As much as I really want to talk about it, I feel we should conclude our Avengers talk
we're
right now.
We're done for the day.
Because I want to have so many conversations with Corey right now about the movie, and we just can't.
I mean, I'm good with that. But we haven't said anything. Like, I haven't almost said anything. I'm not going to. I'll tell you what did happen. I had dinner with my parents last night, and my parents just don't care. So they were asking me about the movie, and they said, you know, like, who dies? And I was like, don't you want to go see the movie? And they were just like, no, we don't care. We'll see it when it gets out, but I don't care if I know now. I'm like, I couldn't do that. I'm just like, no. So I told them because they asked, but that was it, you know. But,
good morning, Thomas Lovett.
You know what I'm saying?
My, Norman Cook, my end game was the fact I had to leave the beach.
I can't get my shares out because I'm on the bridge. Facebook page. I know you did. Yeah. But I mean
yes, good movie. We are talking names of God. Not names of God. We're talking names of Jesus. Specifically today, in Jesus' name, it's a series.
Brandon Scott Murphy saw a breakthrough. I saw people on Facebook saying they went and saw
heard
that.
It was good.
Was it good?
I don't know. I haven't seen it, but I heard it was really
good. I saw a couple
really
people good. Saying that.
Yeah. I heard that was good. Brandon Scott Murphy and Kerry Nicholson are on the live stream at the same time.
Hey, Brandon Scott Murphy. I think we play y'all. Do we play y'all tonight? In El Softball.
Good morning, Thomas Lovett.
What a wonderful devotion for today. I'm excited. We went to the beach. Anybody go to the beach this weekend?
I did not, sir.
I did not.
Any of y'all go to the beach this weekend?
No. Did y'all go to the beach this weekend? The weather was nice. Was
the weather The weather was good. It was windy, and I made the mistake of thinking that because I was cold, and it was windy that I was not going to get burnt. However, as everyone can plainly see,
that
is not the case. Oh,
well,
I feel that burnt.
Nice tan. You're not peeling or nothing.
Mm-mm. It's day two. I'll peel tomorrow.
You think so?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's like a snake skin. It takes
Scott
a little bit
Johnson, time. Good morning, sir.
But yeah. But I did, my kids did let me borrow their boogie boards.
Yes.
And I set up a wall. So I got three kids, Noah, Easton, Paisley.
Yeah.
And so I got Noah to help me dig a little hole in a little like rectangular hole thing in the ground, and we shoved a boogie board in it here, here, and here to block the wind, because when I'm laying down, there you go.
Really?
Good. Really. It was brilliant. It was very
That's
engineering
awesome.
At its finest.
Dude.
It was good.
Good morning, Ed
Cherry.
And then I burped.
I'm proud of you.
And
than a bird.
That's good stuff right there.
Yeah.
We went ice skating this weekend.
Teamwork makes dream work. We did go ice skating.
Yeah.
Steve Hill, I like your style, says, I'm going to see Avengers tomorrow and Wednesday. He's already got his second view picked out. He already knows when he's going to see it for the second
time. We talked about that. Yeah. We'll go see it again.
Dude,
who's going? You said Steve?
Yeah, that's what he said.
Jones!
Good morning.
Good morning.
Melissa apparently posted a picture.
I didn't realize it. It snuck up on me. We are doing a Rugged Maniac 5K race.
Where's it at?
It's Petersburg, Virginia. So
5K?
Mm-hmm.
You and Deanna?
Yep, me and Deanna. And I think a friend of hers from back home.
Is it this weekend?
It's Saturday.
Wow.
Yeah. So I'm looking forward to that. That'll probably be, if I do it. Because she's not, I'll tell you, all she cares about is the popcorn. But we're probably going to spend all day in Virginia because we're up in Virginia. So the race is like 10:15 in the morning. So we'll already be in that area. There's a bunch of good places to go watch the movie there.
Chad Bowen and 25 other people that are watching right now. What did y'all do this weekend? Was it a good weekend?
Yes.
Beautiful weather. And Ed, Cherry, and me are now Facebook official. We are friends.
Yes.
Thank you, Ed, Cherry.
Yes, yes,
amen,
yes.
Amen and amen.
Welcome to Facebook.
Paul's Facebook friendship.
Tuesday night and taking my son Wednesday morning. I love it. See, that's cool, Steve. I love it that people, you know, some people, not everybody's cup of tea is the movies.
Yeah.
But it is mine, man. I love it. You know, my thing is, you go inside of a dark, air-conditioned theater.
Yeah.
And nowadays, most of them have reclining seats.
Oh.
So you're kicking back. You have no choice but to relax.
Are those reclining seats like the most noisy things ever?
They are. Yeah. And when you recline, it is best. It's good. It's good practice to just go ahead and get your setting.
Get yourself straight. Unless you have three kids.
It's not too annoying, but it can be. You're right. It's quiet. If it's one of those loud movies, then you're not going to really hear it.
Yeah.
But I mean, and then you get your sugary soda and your popcorn and candy. I mean, it's a good experience. It's a good time to just relax.
I agree, man.
You know what I mean? You want to see something cool?
I have the night. What? Hey, Steve Hill, what's up with that? What do you get with that? He says he's got the $19.95 a month deal.
That's
at AMC.
The stubs. Don't you do that?
I do that, but I don't do. So there's. He's the next level. So like I'm like.
Your next level, Steve. Next level.
He pays the $19.95.
It's that computer. We know every time Jeremy gets an email, we respond back with funny quotes and hope that it's not important. I think we've signed them up for 4 gym memberships.
That's crazy.
Yeah, Stubbs.
Yeah, so we're the premiere. So we get all the rewards and all that stuff. And
three movies a week.
Because when you take 6 people to the movies.
Oh, man. I don't even want to know.
It's expensive. So every time we go to the movies, we get $5 or $10 in rewards.
Really?
Because it's the movie cost.
Yeah.
And then we spend 40, 50 bucks at the concession stand.
Yeah.
Do you have the verses for today? Because I see one here. Do you have the other ones? Are they in here?
Yes. You going to ask me out loud, Aaron? No, I'm joking.
You didn't hear me.
No, I am. No doubt about that. You got to, man.
What?
But I want to tell you, you want to know my real reason for it?
Yeah.
It's not so much because of the money. It's the variety. Like, I can get down with it, but I like a better. There's something else a lot.
Hey, Jared.
That.
In
the movies.
Where's the verse where he's in the garden? Is it in here?
No.
Okay. I'll take Fresh Market.
Anything he sent over is in there.
You'll see.
He had that one in there.
No. Trust me, it ain't healthy. It is not healthy.
Yeah, it's right here.
Who else is still watching with us? Nikki Davis, good morning.
Nikki!
Steve
Hill. Nikki's been away from us for like 2 weeks.
Yep. Welcome back.
Welcome back, Nikki Davis. We have missed you.
3 movies per week. I like that, Steve Hill. That's pretty good. Mama D says, welcome back, Joel. Good morning to you, Mama D.
Yeah, Joel's back. Man, we got the whole family back today. Look at those. Look at them hearts and those lights,
baby. The trifecta.
Let's go. Let's go.
Liz Mosley says, hey, Nick. Here, look. Y'all want to see something cool? I'm gonna say hey to the last people on the comments.
Oh, wait. Beyond Limits. Man, how do I get off of...
Oh, all right.
What is up? That's Brandon me. Scott Murphy, Ashley Finnegan, Kirk, Norman Kirk, Very Windy, Steve Hill, Avengers is awesome. Melissa Armstrong does have a photo of me with my barriers.
Ooh, I want to see that.
Do you really?
Yeah.
That's weird.
What's
Ed Cherry, good morning. Steve Hill, good morning. Chad Bowen, K-9 Cop, Greenville, North Carolina, good morning. Be safe. Deborah Hill Cherry. I know y'all said good morning to her, but she needs a personal good morning. Donna Phipps Crabtree, we baptized a brother in Christ this weekend.
Nice. Yes. High fives.
High fives.
Very nice. Oh, that was a nice
We got to get our first weekly.
That's a good one. That was really all good. In sync.
That was like a pop pop.
That was. And that last one was all in sync. That's pretty good. Cool. The same time.
Same time. I missed it. You guys are a great way to start the day.
That's right.
We are.
Come on, look at all those likes and those hearts just rolling.
You want to know how many we got? We got 70, 80, we got 8. We got 88 heart.
That's
we got,
wild.
I'm sorry. We got 95 likes. Yeah. 100.
Yeah, baby. Come on.
106.
It's on a roll.
It's going up. I see them. They're crossing. You got 30 seconds.
You got 30 seconds.
You got 30 seconds.
You got 30 seconds.
Welcome back, Joel. I've missed you so. Hey, I started this new standing thing, and somehow Jared has stopped his standing thing. We transitioned. I feel better when
really
I stand.
Really weird.
I don't think I've stood in here the whole time we've been here.
It's really weird.
Too comfy in this chair, man.
Oh, my word. Look at them hearts and likes man. Going across this screen.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Paul and I got conned into going ice skating this weekend. And so
we were sitting there on the skating rink.
Hey, my wife's listening. I didn't get conned. I wanted to go with all my heart, mind, body, and soul.
Okay.
Continue your story.
So
now.
Did I. However, so let me back up. I got conned into getting on the ice. I show up and they're like, hey, all the other dads are doing it. And I'm like, it's just Paul. There's not all the other dads. It's just one.
Yeah.
So we got on the ice and did a little ice skating. I took one tumble and I was done after the tumble.
Yeah, you did well, though.
I made it around 4 or 5 times.
Yeah.
I don't know why, but yeah. Ice skating's harder on my ankles than regular skating.
My
but
man.
I don't mean like,
thank you.
Like, you know, joint-wise. I mean, like, it rubs against my skin.
Yeah, I think
like
it's the ice, the skates, those, it's, you know, you're
they're
using
a little bit more bendy.
And that surprised me, too, because you're really OCD. Like, you're a germaphobe, but you willingly put on skates that have been worn by at least 147,000 other people.
I had a brand new pair of socks on.
Oh.
Were they thick socks?
Yep.
All right, that explains it.
He took a bath later on that night.
I did too. You know I did.
Oh my
man, this verse.
The things we did for
man,
our kids.
Yeah.
I love this.
So I love the devotion today because it's something that I rely on quite a bit. Like, we all rely on prayer.
Yeah.
You know, most of us anyway, when times are hard or we need to press into Jesus. But what about just saying his name? You know, what about just calling on the name of Jesus? And we have this verse here in conjunction with the devotion brought to us by the JLD, Brandon Nicholson. We love you so much, brother. Thank you for this. For where two or three gather in my name, there am I with them. Matthew 18:20. And I love it because you know what I kind of think of, and I don't want to sound selfish, but I think about this.
Yep.
You know, at first, you know, where two or three gather in my name. And then I think about all the other people out there who are going to, you know, just bring this verse to fruition just by leaning on each other and just calling on the name of Jesus through times of, it doesn't even have to be strife. It can be praise, man. You know what I mean? And I love it. You know, there's power in the name of Jesus.
Yeah, and we got, and I love this because Mondays we always get a visit from Johnny Jones, the pastor at Harbor
Church
in Washington, North Carolina, comes, hangs out with us.
Our brother.
Yeah, brother from another and different mother. I remember that. So what's going on, Johnny? What do you think?
Brother from the same mother.
Yeah, yeah. Go.
Remember that.
How you going?
Brother from the same mother.
Oh, man. Nice.
You remember that?
Sarah versus Hagar.
Oh,
Sarah, Grace, Hagar.
Here
works.
Comes the knowledge.
Oh, yeah, come on, somebody. Well.
So what do you think in Jesus' name?
Man, that's powerful. I mean, what can you say about that?
Yeah.
The most powerful. You talk about these superhero Avenger movies. Everybody's crazy. And I'm not as into it as everybody else. I figured I'll see it when it comes out on DVD in the Walmart kiosk. I'll go get it maybe. And, and you know, people are stoked about that.
Yeah.
And that's cool.
Yep.
And I'm not belittling that, but I'm saying, okay, but none of that's real.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But there is a real name that's more powerful than any superhero that's ever walked the face of the earth.
Yeah.
And here's the deal, though. He gave us his name.
Yeah.
So, like, whatever causes that superhero to be the superhero. So, Superman, it was what, the cape?
Yeah.
For Batman, it was, I don't know what Batman's thing was. Spider-Man, it was his suit.
Yeah.
But with Jesus, he just gave us his name.
Yep.
And he says, you can use this. This is my name. In this name, there's all authority. There's all power.
Yep.
You can use my name. And when you gather together in my name, I'm going to be right there with y'all.
Yeah,
that's the guarantee. So, man, that's incredible.
I love that.
Nothing else on the face of the earth has this except those who believe in Jesus. And as believers in Jesus, we have the name.
You know what? I'm so thankful for that, and thankful that we have more time to talk about this. This is huge right here.
Boom.
It's something that's simple, but it's so important. Yeah. It's so very important.
Powerful.
So excited to be talking more about this. We got one more segment in this hour, and then we got a whole another hour. So hang with us here on 98.3 The Bridge. We love you guys.
Come on.
Yeah, so I love it because Paul writes to the Philippian church that at the name of Jesus,
every knee
is going to bow, and every tongue is going to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Yep.
You see, there's people living now that say, you know, Jesus don't exist. Your God don't exist. You know that one day, every knee is going to bow and every tongue is going to confess that He is Lord. No matter what you say you're going to do now or say you're not going to do now.
That's right.
You're going to.
Yeah.
And it's you see this perfect picture because you got Jesus Christ who came to earth, took on the form of man, the Bible says humbled himself to take on the form of man. You got God taking on the form of servant, being born in a manger, but you have a lamb. That is not the picture that John creates in Revelation, that Daniel writes of.
Yeah.
Because when Christ comes back, it's not the lamb anymore. He's coming back, and he's coming back for his saints. He's coming back for his bride.
Yep. Yeah.
And he's coming back with fire in his eyes.
Yep.
Fire!
Because Christians have been persecuted.
Yeah.
And he's coming back for his people. You better believe you have got a Paisley or Easton, you know, if they come home and they're like, man, somebody gave me a hard time at school today, or so-and-so said this at school today, you know, that little bit of protective mode comes like, can you imagine what Christ feels like right now? And it says that he's waiting for the vial to fill up, which is the prayers of the saint. And when it hits that tipping point, God says, go get my people.
Absolutely.
Ain't nothing like it. But, man, we are going into that. And we're really going to get into the garden.
Yeah, that's like what I'm going to say. You know, Johnny was saying, and we can probably bring this up next segment.
Yeah.
But talking about the power of, you know, the different superheroes with Batman and Superman and Iron Man and Spider-Man and Captain, all these people, right?
Yep.
In John chapter 18 and verse 6, it says, they asked Jesus who he was. And Jesus said, Jesus asked them, who are you looking for? And they said, Jesus of Nazareth. Jesus said, I am he. And the Bible says that they drew back and fell to the ground.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like Jesus's voice was so, there's so much power in that name that it causes them to draw back and to fall.
Now,
and
are we going to elaborate on this on the air too? Mm-hmm. This is perfect. I'm excited.
Yeah.
It's going to be good. There's a lot going on. There's a lot going on in that picture. You said and there, so keep going with it.
No, I'm...
What's that?
Nope. Well, I don't remember what the and was now.
So, this is really cool. I got so much going through my mind right now. Robbie Gallaty.
Yeah.
Wrote a book. And
I like him a lot.
And I learned a lot of stuff from it because... Something about you want to make sure that all the books that you read pull from Scripture. This is nothing but unpacking Scripture. Their own ideas are nothing but, in there somewhere, but it is Scripture, scripturally sound and based.
Scripturally sound.
That being said, you have to read the Gospels. You have to read the Bible initially. The first rule in interpretation, you're going to interpret the Bible. You have to read it in its original setting.
Right.
Okay, how did the original audience hear it? Okay? That's the number one rule of interpretation. You don't read, what does it mean in 2019? You gotta remember, what did it mean in 23, 24 AD, 64 AD when Paul wrote some of his. And look at it this way. When Jesus is in the Garden of Gethsemane, he utters some words.
Right.
That Jews won't utter, and we're going to go back. When Jesus says, I am he, the phrase I am, Jews cannot say that phrase out of reverence.
Yeah.
And you're like, well, why does that make sense? This goes back all the way to Exodus and Moses, the burning bush. When Moses is told to go rescue the people out of captivity, and God is saying, I'm calling you, you specifically, Moses, I'm calling you to do it. And Moses says, they're never going to believe me. Who do I tell them sent me? We learned the name of God for the first time. Mm-hmm. He goes, I am. Tell them I am sent you. From that moment forward, Jews would not say the phrase I am out of reverence for God. They didn't want to even come close to saying the name of God.
Right.
Because, I mean, you're talking about a group of people who were only going to walk a certain number of steps on the Sabbath, because any more than that was considered a work. And they weren't, it was against the law to work on the Sabbath, so they would only walk a certain number of steps. I mean, these people by age 12 would have the Torah memorized verbatim. You think you memorize one Bible verse and you're awesome. These guys remembered the first five books of the Bible by age 12.
Yep.
Okay, it's significant. They weren't going to utter the name I am at all. Jesus steps on the scene and they say, these people who don't do it, they said, where's Jesus of Nazareth? And he goes, I am he.
Yeah.
So what he is invoking and what he is saying is, I am God. And it happens at least three times that we know about. When he's talking to Peter, and he calls Peter to walk out on the water. John. He walks. It's in the Gospels, but specifically this one, I believe, is John. It's either Luke or John. But he calls Peter to, the disciples leave, and they're out, and it's storming. And two things happen. Jesus is about to walk past the boat. And the Bible specifically says that Jesus is going to pass them by. He intended to pass them by. They're in a storm. Like, they're fearful for their life. Jesus is walking on water, and he's not even walking to them. He intends to pass them by, the Bible says. It doesn't make sense until you go back to Exodus.
Yeah.
What did God have to do to Moses? Moses could not take on. Moses said, let me see you, Lord. Let me see you, God. And God goes, you can't see me and live. Here's what we're going to do. I'm going to hide you in a rock, and I'm going to pass by. And when I pass by, you're going to be able to see a glimpse of my glory. And you're like, okay, well, that seems cool. He does it again to Elijah. I'm going to pass by and let you see my glory. And you're like, okay. Well, now, when you look at Jesus on the water, it makes perfect sense when he intends to pass them by. Because he is God. And you got to look at it that way. And then when they say, oh, it's a ghost, he goes, no, I am. And once again, that's the first time he proclaims to his disciples that I am God, is on the water as he's standing, conquering nature. I mean, he's standing on water, and he says, I am. That's a proclamation, guys. That is him saying, I am the God.
Mm-hmm. It's awesome.
And then it falls back to Gethsemane again when he does it. It is so powerful.
So to go off of what all that, because that was beautiful.
That was a lot of me talking, and
no,
I'm
it
sorry.
Was, no, don't apologize for nothing, but I got something for you. I love what you just said, and then right on time, Donna Phipps Crabtree, she says this right here, and I can identify with this. She says, there are times when I can't pray because I just don't have the words to say. I'm so distraught. One of my favorite verses in the Bible is Romans 8:26. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know what to pray for as we ought, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. That's awesome. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
And I know what she's talking about. Sometimes you just feel so overwhelmed, and you just kind of like, well, I just don't know, you know, where to go from here. Or I have this funk. I mean, I don't know what to say. I don't want to do. You don't have to worry about that.
Yes.
You know what I mean? That is, our God is so great that we don't have to worry about sometimes what to pray for.
Because
we don't even know what we need sometimes.
Yep.
That's the level change.
Yeah.
Like our God, we don't even know what we need sometimes, but our God, yeah. Come on, our God
up in here
knows everything we need. He knows everything we're going to need.
Yeah.
And even though we can't put it into words, he's able to just say, just don't worry about it. You know, just press into me. Just go into your spirit right now and just relax. I've got this. And we can't even make words for it. And he takes it away from there. It's just awesome.
Yeah,
that's really good.
It's beautiful, man. I love it. And that was, thank you, Donna Crabtree, for that. Right on time with what Paul.
Right on time.
Everything with Paul just said. Hey, Paul having church in here this morning.
Man, you got
and
to.
And then you come on top of that. That's perfect. That works perfect together. Mm-hmm. And Carrie Nicholson's right. Church every morning. I love it. That's awesome. That's some good stuff right there.
And we can't, I see, and I had to stop short, and I know it seemed like I talk a lot, but the phrase I am, when specifically referring to God, and Jesus steps on and sees it, and our devotions are going to turn, because this is a series, are going to turn into the I am statements that Jesus makes. You know, I am the bread of life. I am the vine. You are the branches. When he's doing that, every time he is saying I am, he is saying I am God. I am God. I am God. Jews would never say it. Jesus was a Jew. I don't want to dissect next week's stuff, but it's really, man, it is good.
That's some good stuff, man. That is awesome. I love it. I love it.
Brandon, this is good, man. Thank you.
Yes, it is. Some people are loving this, too. And see, here we go. Corey for Law. I was thinking about this, and just like Donna Crabtree said, but it's just sometimes I just say, Jesus, help me, Jesus. I need you, Jesus. And you know, I can identify with that. That's some good stuff right there. I've done that many a times. Sometimes that's all you can say, man, but that's all you need to say.
Can you write it? Because I don't see it yet.
We're writing down prayer requests.
Yeah. And it's Monday. We do it every day, but specifically on Monday. If you have a prayer request, something that's going on this week you need us to pray for,
saw Jessica.
Let us know. Drop it down there. For the returning family, you know we pray at the end of these devotions, definitely on the live stream.
Yes.
So, yeah, get them up here. We will pray with you. Hey, Miss Kathy and Mark Verdon. What is going on?
I don't know why. I was cold over the weekend, man.
I'm cold now that my face is on fire. I look like a different person.
You look like a different person, man.
I can't see pictures up here. Did Melissa post that picture?
I never saw the picture, Melissa.
We got a minute and a half.
Go ahead.
Minute and a half. Go ahead. I feel she did because that's the hearts.
Yes, she did. Okay, got
did
it.
She put, do you have the picture?
I do have the picture.
What's she?
Dude. That's it.
I look very comfortable.
You look very comfortable, Paul. You're a very comfortable looking fella right there.
Look at those shorts. I got them from Wings. They were like $13.
I like it, man. Yeah. Dude, I'm impressed. Good stuff right there, baby. Good stuff right there.
What's up, guys? Says Mark Burton.
Mark. You coming to that ball game tonight, Mark Burton? I know you are.
Yeah, the church softball team has played three games. A total of 3 games and a total of 4 innings. Five innings, because they have what's called the mercy rule.
45.
If you're losing by 20 points in one inning or something like that, they cut the game off. And
20
like,
points
hey,
at the end of the third.
We got better things to do.
15 at the end of the fourth. So, yeah, we need to pray for Miss Bonnie. Good call, Mark Verdon.
Yeah. All right, we're on. Hey, thanks, Mark, for remembering that. Yeah, so when they go looking for Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane, mm-hmm. they say, "Where is Jesus of Nazareth?" And he goes, "I am he." And then they immediately fall to the ground.
Mm,
yeah. And you see this just a king. Yeah. You see a king right now willingly laying down his life. And you're like, man, you got to remember the people who went to get him, they weren't just police officers. They weren't just that. They were Jews.
Yeah.
All right. Because they were sent out by the Sanhedrin. They were Jews. Okay. So when Jesus proclaims, "I am he," you got to understand that Jews would not use that phrase in conjunction the way he does. They would not utter the words "I am." Ever since Moses found out from God that God's name was "I am," Jews would not, out of reverence for God, use that phrase at all. Okay, but Jesus proclaims it. "I am he," and he's saying, "I'm God, guys. Check it out." And they fall down to the ground in reverence for the word.
Yes,
and that is so. That's so awesome.
Yes. What you think about that, Johnny Jones?
Powerful. So tap into what you were saying earlier, Paul, about the name of Jesus during the break. You were talking about how at the name of Jesus, every knee will bow, every tongue will confess.
Yeah.
Yeah, share that.
That's another one. In Philippians, Paul writes to the church at Philippi, and he goes, hey, at the, and this is one day, there's a lot of people out there, and you might be going to work right now, and you say, man, nobody believes. Not only don't they believe, they start arguments, and they get to the point of being hostile, and they're like, God doesn't exist.
Right.
Why are you playing games? Understand this one day, especially our church planners who are out there right now, and it is hard, and you might be like in Japan or in Canada, one of those, and you're surrounded by people that is less than 1% of the population Christian. And that might be the case right now. Understand that, like Paul proclaims, every knee will bow, every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord one day. Mm-hmm. What a beautiful hope we have.
It's beautiful, man.
So you have two components there. You got the then, that's going to happen then. That definitely is going to happen then. But then you have the now. You got the then and the now. So right now, how does the name of Jesus help me? You know, like I've got to go in here and I've got to go to work and I got to sit down with some folks and the girl two cubicles down is mad at me from because I didn't bring back her Tupperware on time last week.
That reminds me, right? You got all kinds of stuff, right?
And every atmosphere has it because we're humans and we're human beings and people are going to have moods and just, you know, so how does the name, I know what's going to happen then, but how does the name help me now?
Right.
And here's how it helps us now. It's according to our faith.
Yes.
Be it done unto you. I happened to do some channel surfing last night. Never seen this show before. I'm going to try to tune in now every Sunday night. It's called How the Lottery Changed My Life. This is a show I watched last night, right? And you know what these people had in common, several of these folks? They actually believed they were going to win the lottery. Mm-hmm. One lady actually wrote down $12 million on a piece of paper, stuck it under her pillow. Mm-hmm. For a long time, and she won $12 million. Now, I'm not trying to tell you the secrets of winning the lottery, but here's the thought that hit me. If these people have that much faith in winning the lottery,
right,
which the chances are very, very limited that will happen, how much more can we put our faith in the name of Jesus that we've been given that we can use every day of our life?
Right.
And as you said, Paul, sometimes all you can say is just the name Jesus. Corey, I think you said that too. Sometimes all you can say is the name of Jesus. But listen, that's not a little. That's a lot. That's not a little. That's a whole lot.
Yep.
That is the name that's above every name. If we put our faith and trust in it, man, we can see God move just through the name.
Yes.
That's right. We are coming back with more in Jesus' name. In hour number two, you're listening to the Beyond Limits Morning Crew on 98.3 The Bridge.
Jared, we're not going to talk about Avengers. We're not.
Matter of fact, me mentioning the name right now, Avengers, is a little too much. We already got it out of our system, Jared Ryan. We're not talking about it. No spoilers up in this room.
No. I thought you were talking to me. I was like, dude, we're not talking about it.
No, it was Jared Ryan. Oh, man.
Whoa, boy. Man.
I love it.
Power in the name of Jesus.
There's power.
I love that song.
Have you had that name there?
Man, you guys are awesome. 547 likes.
Yes.
272 hearts. And apparently we said six really funny things. Because I got the little crying face, that probably came when Melissa posted my picture of me laying out on the beach.
Yeah, break every chain. That's a problem. Who sang that?
Is it Bethel?
We had a version.
Yeah,
we had a version
that
we played. Yeah,
get,
have it ready so we can play it.
Maybe after next segment.
Come on.
Hey, look, our hearts are catching up. I'm really going to try and do this. Let's see how this works. I don't know how to do this. I think I should know how to do this. If I'm on Wi-Fi, I can definitely do this.
I want y'all to see what it looks like.
When y'all do this, when y'all come in, check this out.
Oh yeah, show all the hearts and all the love and all the likes. Oh man,
make sure my Wi-Fi is turned on. Oh, it's not connected. There we go. But yeah, keep the hearts coming. I'm gonna show you because this is beautiful, 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 beautiful.
Still, can I walk out to get my coffee? And it's still going.
I encourage hearts.
I love hearts. Y'all know the deal. I love me some hearts. Remember back at Chaco when they would do the hearts and they still doing like this, it's going to cause me, oh, look at all this love. All the love. Keep it all, man. Too all there. Oh, man, all that love. It's beautiful. killing it. They're killing it. Let's see here. Man.
Sup, guys.
Here we go. That is y'all what it looks awesome. Like. Now tap that button real fast.
Best viewers and listeners anywhere and everywhere. Come on.
This is what we see when y'all do that.
Good morning, Karen Cooper.
That is so cool. Thank y'all so much for that.
Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Now.
Whoa.
Can we talk about this right here? Because while...
What in the world is that?
I'm going to tell you what it is. While California is telling everybody, hey, no straws. It's illegal to have straws because environment.
Right.
CVS says, thank you for purchasing a bottle of water. I got a bottle of water in
one
CVS.
Bottle.
This is my receipt for a bottle
one
of
bottle.
Water at CVS.
Boy, that had to have been like an old...
This was yesterday.
Now I'm telling you,
but let me
they're
see.
Terrible.
No, keep, is it
Walgreens and CVS, man, they get the longest receipts.
Yeah. I really, it's like...
Walgreens aren't even that long.
It's like it should be written on papyrus paper.
It's like they...
Like old scroll.
They use that to measure the temple. You know? It's yeah. Like, go, like,
that's
build
wild.
It six
that's
CVS
wild.
Receipts wide and
that's
eight
crazy.
CVS receipts tall.
I almost
in the
put
world.
It out on Facebook last night.
I was
night.
Wondering, I was out.
Good morning, Karen Cooper.
I was thinking that maybe that was like somebody's old receipt that didn't get tore off, but clearly
no.
It's not.
No, dude.
This
it's
crazy.
Out of
control. And it just keeps coming out, and it's fast, like...
And look, let me... Look. Yep. So you got $2 off Colgate toothpaste.
I don't even use Colgate.
$2 off... Skincare something. I can't even pronounce it. $2 off $6 Nature Valley
gracious.
Fiber One Bar.
I might use that.
$2 off $8 eye care or ear care.
It gives you some fiber, Johnny.
$2 off Crest.
Yeah, some
like
fiber.
Just,
so you're
in
fluid.
Conjunction with the...
So you're fluid.
Hey, what's going on over there, Johnny?
Well,
Money?
This is,
Johnny
what's going on
mic?
Johnny breaking his mic, man?
This is,
Johnny did a mic drop.
Come on now.
Johnny, has your phone always been broke?
Man, I'm telling you, man.
Corey Falal said they could lower their prices, but they still got to pay for ink.
Pay for ink?
Yeah, that receipt. That receipt.
Gracious, man. What in the world?
Was he leaving this computer here? Was he just leaving it temporarily?
Yeah.
If he was donating it to the cause.
He had one that he was going to try to donate, but he couldn't get it rolling.
See, look, we listen to y'all. Corey said it works better when the comments are down at the bottom, and the comments are at the bottom.
Man,
this is your show.
Absolutely.
Dead Sea Scrolls. Boom.
Is that what it is? Somebody say that?
Yeah. I hear you.
That's funny.
Hey, prayer request. So if I missed any prayer requests, y'all, if you've seen them, let me know.
Yeah, definitely.
I got Rachel Fight and Bonnie Yall so far.
Bonnie Yall,
Robbie
yes.
Strayer, good morning, sir.
Robbie Strayer, he's back.
Yep, he just joined.
Robbie.
Good morning, Robbie.
I'm gonna do the slow clap for him. Yeah, welcome back, Robbie.
It might take him a minute to get it.
You did good, man. You did good at being gone and coming back.
Yes. They were like traveling the world.
Yeah.
Traveling the world?
Well, traveling the state.
And Brandon's leaving today to go to
Disney World.
Yep. Everybody's going places.
Going places, and that's
what I'm talking about.
I'm just going to work.
Yeah, we got revival coming.
Johnny
up this
Jones
weekend at church.
North Florida.
Revival.
Joel on a cruise. Shoot.
Oh, Dad.
Told me
Dad
to step off
and go
do something.
He did.
You know, like setting up revival. That was really good. He did a really good job.
Hey, Robbie says your hair looks luxurious.
That's what I'm looking at. I noticed that comment. I don't know why he's saying that,
Johnny,
Robbie.
What do you think
about
that word? I haven't heard
that
word said
that.
In a while.
I know why he's saying that.
Lotion.
That just got it.
Yes, but the man said...
So I'm at Harris Teeter last night.
The man said...
What'd you say?
Because he's using lotion.
Using lotion. Get that sheen. If you want that good sheen...
So here's the thing.
Oh.
Robbie's talking. I was at here. Melissa texted me. Have y'all ever noticed when I start a story, it typically progresses this way, but my stories always progress this way, and then they start. It's like I never know where to start them correctly. Melissa texts me and goes, "Hey, pick up trash bags, cat food, and something else on the way home." Well, it's like her fourth time texting me that. So I'm at Harris Teeter, and Robbie Strayer is at Harris Teeter. And I'm picking out hair shampoo.
Yes.
Which is where the comment, it was really a simple story I was telling just now. It is where this comment comes from. And I couldn't, I said, hey, Robbie, have you ever heard of, like, anything like hair thickening shampoo? You know, make it thicker, make it look like it's more presentable.
Right.
I'm not ashamed. I'm a man, Robbie. I lose hair.
Yeah.
Clearly. See? You can't subtly make fun of me, Robbie. I'll do it out loud.
Yeah.
I don't think
he
But he's got a shaved head.
He wasn't making fun of you.
I know.
He was complimenting me. Whatever shampoo you found, he was saying worked.
I'm just smiling awkwardly at the camera. To Robbie.
man.
So what y'all's Mondays look like? What is your... It's only going to be 73 degrees today.
Man.
Right? No rain, 73, maybe a little humidity today.
Yeah.
I'm excited about our day today, y'all.
Did you get Norman Kirk?
Absolutely.
Yes.
I am as well.
Just him in general?
Yes. Norman Kirk, pray for him. He's got some sort of bug.
Ugh.
Some sort of bug going on. Don't like that.
Don't like that at all.
Just a few weeks
ago. Don't like it.
You remember that episode where we talked about biggest fears?
Yeah. I wasn't even here and I remember it.
Yeah. Biggest fears. We did it. We did an episode back in the day of our biggest fears. And my biggest fear is the stomach bug.
Work, gym, and softball, says Brandon Scott Murphy. That sounds like a good day.
Oh, I hear you softball, man. Baby.
They're,
I hear you softball, Brandon
Murphy.
They're playing
each other tonight in softball.
Are they?
Yes. Ignite is playing Temple. And it's going to be an awesome game.
Yeah, I just hope we score a run. I hope we don't get skunked. Y'all, look. Last game, I hit a ball to short. And I'm running. In my mind, I'm running like a 4.4. In reality, I'm probably running like an 8.4.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
But as fast as I can go down this line trying to beat out this ground ball. And I obviously don't beat out the throw. But I was so gassed.
Now, do you run through?
Yes.
You do? Okay.
I ran
you give
through.
It all. Yep.
I gave it my all. I was so gassed. I turn around. I could barely make it to the other team's dugout before they pitch the next pitch.
Right.
All right. So I go through their dugout and walk around so I don't have to... Actually, I can take my time getting back to my dugout.
Dugout?
Before I get back to the dugout, we already had 3 outs. So I have to, after just running down to first base, I have to then run into the dugout to get my glove and run out to left center field.
Gracious.
And the first guy hit it in the gap. So then I had to run in the gap. It was a tough way.
Hey, man.
4 minute period there.
It's all about growing together out there. Like, I'm pretty sure I'll be there tonight. Not to play. I'm a kid. Melissa's working. And but I'm going to be there to root you on.
Thanks, buddy.
Brandon, it's going to be a fun game.
I went 1-for-2 last game.
If it starts at 8:30, I would plan on being in bed by 9.
Yeah.
9 o'clock?
Yeah. The game starts at 8:30. They played 3 games and
gracious.
A total of 5 innings.
Yeah, we're fantastic. Don't look at me like that, Joe.
They got the mercy rule. Mercy rule. It's like 20
points. Runs after 3 innings.
It's like basketball.
That's
scores.
Almost like that's too much. 20 runs? That's a lot of runs before they finally say, yeah,
well,
that's enough.
It,
yeah. But hey, I don't know.
Oh.
Donna Phipps Crabtree says, I got work, home, cook supper, and work on a watercolor portrait. That is a busy day, Donna.
Really
busy,
is.
Busy day.
What are you talking about, roast? Ain't nobody talking about food, Brandon.
Yeah, I get my cardio in every game. And, woo!
Yeah.
No, Corey. If I would have jogged across the field, they would have thrown the ball anyway.
Mark Vernon says, Corey, you need to come play. Would you play?
I would.
If you had time?
If I had time, yeah, I would.
Show up, they'll let you play.
Yeah. I would, but I don't think I had time.
Danny said he busted his knees coming around third.
Ashley.
Danny made it to third?
Yeah. Ashley Austin, he pulled a muscle.
Right. There's a bunch of people out there pulling muscles.
Yeah, so Mark, so I hit this ground ball, and I hustle down first baseline and have to walk around. So I look up, and the first pitch after me, Mark was up after me. He did the hit at the exact same guy. He hustled down the base, and then he's having to walk right behind me. And then the next guy got out, so him and I are both running out there trying to get our stuff together. Oh, it's crazy.
Can I say that we have 26 people on right now?
Yes.
All of our top fans are watching
I'm
right now.
I'm telling you.
Aww.
I wanted to know, hey, Donna Crabtree, just how far are you away from Niagara Falls? I might be going up there
that would be
in
cool.
June. Yes.
That would be cool.
I just thought about that. Donna Crabtree, how far are you away from Niagara Falls in Canada? I don't know. I got to see if I can get my passport in time. We might just have to settle for the New York side of Niagara Falls, but that is somewhere I'm going in a couple months.
Yeah, but she could come over to that side. Yeah,
she
y'all
could
meet. That'd be really cool.
She could. That'd be wonderful.
That would be awesome.
I guarantee.
Very nice.
What would happen is that Corey ends up being a church planner after that.
12 hours. Yeah, you ain't that close.
No.
All right, so you're going to need to start planning right now, Donna Crabtree, for a 12-hour trip in July.
Goodness gracious. She's up there then.
She's about as far as we are away from it.
She's saying she's 12 hours from. So Donna Crabtree, I'm going to tell them, she's saying she's 12 hours from Niagara Falls, but she's in Canada, right?
Yeah.
We're going up for a wedding Dundee, New York. It's near Ithaca, New York, near where Cornell University is.
Yep.
That is 3 hours from Niagara Falls. So we figure, well, we're that
there,
far north,
yeah.
We might as well go the extra 3 hours.
Yes.
And go.
She said,
come on by. So that's why we're going to be in that part of New York, and we're going to still have to drive like 3 hours to get to it. So
above Maine.
Wow. Yeah.
Above Maine.
I don't know. Is that Ontario?
She's in... I know where she's at, and my mind just went New Brunswick.
See, I'd like to have a conversation with church planners. That is so cool to say. All right, comfort and safety. What we're gonna do? Complete different things, you know.
Yes.
So that's cool. Congratulations, Donna, on being that person. You and your team.
That is really cold.
Yes. Corey Falls says that's like Arctic Circle North. Holy cow!
it is most.
I was gonna say she's got to be up there pretty far.
Yes. Me and Elizabeth went on a date this weekend.
You did go on a date this weekend.
Yes, we had like a full day date.
Moore, what's up?
It was awesome.
Yes.
We did a
full day date.
Yeah, we went and we did some shopping. We went and had a lunch at Optivola.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we had a little lunch there. It was good. I had their pizza.
Yeah.
I had a meatball pizza. It was
good.
Fantastic. Yes. do what?
He said 1 minute, and I quietly, without interrupting you, which now didn't matter, I said 1 minute to you, sir, and he said 1 minute to you, but we did it quietly, but now we did it aloud.
1 minute. Listen here.
We got
1 minute. 1 minute.
Hey, can we all say happy birthday to Norman Kirk's wife?
Ashley Finnegan.
Happy
birthday.
Happy birthday.
Ashley Kirk.
Hey, can we whisper sing her happy birthday?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, dear Ashley
Norman Kirk.
Happy birthday to you.
We're going on the radio. Oh, it's Ashley. What's
seven?
I don't know, but it's not Norman.
Oh, hey.
That was weird.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the second hour of the Beyond Limits morning show here on your very own 98.3 The Bridge. Most encouraging music for your positive day. We are loving this radio show this morning. Got an awesome devotional brought to you by the one and only Brandon Nicholson. We love him so much, man. 57 outside. The clouds have cleared up just a little bit. Looking at a high of around 70 degrees.
Yeah.
You're about to start your week off just the way you need to.
That's a
with
good
your
day.
With your friends here talking about Jesus and
friends.
How there's power
aww.
In his
hey,
name.
Friends.
Absolutely.
Hey, we want to know, what can we pray with you for? Hop
yes,
on the
we
live
do.
Stream, search your daily show. You can go to 98.3 The Bridge's Facebook page. We share it out. Or you can text us at 252-495-0024 and let us know what we can pray with you for.
Yes. Because we love praying with you guys.
Yes.
Better believe it. It makes a difference. And I love where the devotion is headed today, because with that, with the praying with you guys, We're talking about how there's power in the name of Jesus, and we've had so much feedback. As I always say, the best listeners and viewers out there, we love you guys and support. And it is so true, man. They are, because not only do they love and support us, they help us when it comes to devotions like this, because they tell us directly how it impacts them and how they can relate to it.
We get instant feedback.
Yes. It's so awesome, man. They're up here dropping scripture. They're up here talking about how, you know, they are identifying with exactly what we are talking about. And I just love the focus for today. Just say Jesus. That's all you need to do sometimes is just say Jesus.
Sometimes that's all you can do.
Like, listen to this comment right here. Donna Crabtree, there are times when I can't pray because I just don't know the words to say.
Yeah.
I'm so distraught. One of my favorite verses in the Bible is Romans 8:26. Try to break it down like that fancy. See what happens. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know what to pray for as we ought, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. I'm so glad Jesus knows my heart in times of trouble. I identify with that so well. Sometimes in life, you know, we don't know what to say.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes we could be, sometimes it don't even have to be negative. Sometimes we could just be caught up in so much praise.
Yeah.
Just, and all we know how to say is just thank you, Jesus. You know, because what can we really give other than ourselves and our love? I mean, you feel overwhelmed sometimes just how much God blesses you. And then on the same token, sometimes we feel overwhelmed with how much we can't control and circumstances of life, you know, and then we just, you know, fall to our knees and we're in our car and we're just sitting there, and all we can think is to say the word Jesus, the name Jesus, the powerful name of Jesus.
Yeah, that's beautiful. I love what Jared said yesterday in church, and I love it when he gets the big guys because he don't know what I'm going to say now, but worshiping yesterday, I was like, man, the sound, and you were like, I'm sorry. I was caught up in worshiping. Like, he was running sound yesterday, but he got so involved in just worshiping Jesus that, you know,
and that's a real thing.
Part of it.
Yeah.
It's a real thing. It's a beautiful thing.
Yeah. Everybody was like, music's a little loud. And I'm like, yeah, totally my fault. Totally my fault. I wasn't paying attention there for a minute.
You should turn and look at him and be like, I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. I was worshiping. I was getting my worship on.
Awesome.
I love it. That's awesome, man.
That's kind of what it was like, though. Joel, welcome back, sir.
Yes, Joel.
It is good. Oh, Joel doesn't have the microphone.
Doesn't have the mic right
now. Oh, man. Dude, it's good to have you back, buddy.
I'm glad to be back.
Did you have fun cruising?
Sure did. It was awesome.
Did you eat a lot of food?
I did.
So you can order, like, food day and night, right, on a cruise ship?
You can eat anything you want in the dining room. And then they have buffets all over the ship.
So you ate a bunch.
Yeah, I had a shrimp cocktail every night.
I can't tell.
No, I didn't gain
anything.
I'm
so jelly, bro.
He weighed 77 pounds before and after his cruise.
Yes, he did.
I'm joking. I'm
telling you, man.
Dude, hey, when we get back, we are talking about an Hey Corey trip. We see you on the live stream. Hop up on the live stream. You could do that by getting on the Bridge FM. They've shared it out. Or you can hop up on your daily show on Facebook. Either way, you're going to see us. Hang out with us. Talk with us. Let us know if there's something we could pray with you for. But don't you dare go anywhere. You're listening to Beyond Limits on 98.3, The Bridge.
What's everybody talking about this morning? Joe asked Jared about his raise. What's that? You got a raise?
No. She told me she was giving me a raise.
Oh.
For doing the producer duty last week. Oh, you
said. Gracious sakes.
Donna Crabtree. Dude.
I got to put this into perspective.
Raw cookies, man.
Were you here for that?
No, he was not, and it was so good.
That's right. He asked if we saved some.
We did not save any for Joel.
No, we inhaled them cookies.
Gracious sakes.
Cookies.
So just to put this, have we ever put it into perspective, given a logistical, like, how far Donna Crabtree is away from us?
No.
So New Brunswick, Canada. Donna, I'm bragging on you for a moment. New Brunswick is 19 hours and 27 minutes away from here. 1,196 miles away. It's almost 2,000. Excuse me. Yeah, almost two. Excuse me. Not what I was saying. It's almost 1,200 miles away. And she watches with us like every morning, man. New Brunswick, Canada.
That's up there.
19 hours and 27 minutes. Donna Crabtree.
That's.
We love you. We thank you so much.
That's close to Nova Scotia.
Yeah. It's up there, Jack. Well, that's I had to do that because when I talked about me going to Niagara Falls, how far are you away? And she said, I thought she... Now, I forget, Canada is a big, big area.
It's a big... It's what a do they call country. Them up there? They call them territories.
Yes. So I'm like, okay. You know, I knew that, but I was like, well, she might be close to it. I don't know. She's up there, bro. When she said I'm 12 hours away from Niagara Falls, I'm like, she must be really up there.
Look how big... I've never looked... Look how big Quebec is.
Yeah.
Dude, like... That's like almost the United States.
That's yeah. crazy, man. That's wild.
Yeah. All right. So she's up there.
Welcome to geography, guys.
Yeah. Hey.
I had to do that. I don't know why. She's always, and you know, she dropped that nice bit of scripture and that tidbit and shared with us. I figured, you know what?
Tidbit.
Bless her. Let me see.
Corey Tripp.
4 hours. She's 4 hours from Nova Scotia.
Hey, guys. Dropping a few reminders on here. Revival at Temple FWB Church this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Yep.
Come get you some Jesus.
Amen. Darren Gibbs.
Guess Amen. Who will be there?
Me.
I'll be there. Corey will be there.
Gibbs. Darren G. Gibbs. Yeah.
Nicole Denmark, Fire Tower Animal Clinic. Hey.
Nicole? What is happening?
So we
I like
have.
Your shirt.
Bless you.
Yeah, that's right.
I've had it for a little
Carpenter's
while.
Chapel shirt, right?
Shirt. Carpenter's Shop.
Hey, Carpenter's Shop.
Oh, no, I think they still sell them. Very nice. Very nice shirts.
We were talking about a church sign that my dad put up.
Which one?
Last week.
We are divine.
No, he is divine.
He is divine. We are de-branches.
Branches.
Yeah. So hey, everybody on Fire Tower, we are
divine.
He is divine.
He is divine.
We are de-branches.
We are de-branches.
Mon.
And my wife goes, oh my goodness, did you see that sign your dad put up? And I'm like, I know, I did not. And she said, it was so funny. And she told me what it was, and I was like, oh no.
Yes.
And then I had somebody else say the same thing to me. Like some random person. Like, that, I mean, I know them. They weren't just like, hey, in the middle of Walmart, do you go to Temple?
Have you seen Temple Church?
No. But they were like, dude, I laughed so hard at that sign your dad put up. And I was like, which one?
Oh my word. 804 hearts, 577 thumbs up.
Y'all hear that out there?
44 laughing peoples. Megan Wooten.
That's how awesome y'all are. That's just a little taste. Johnny, I'm finna go old Chaco style in here. You better look. We better close that door, Jack. He's like, Johnny's like, hey.
It's hot in here.
Johnny, he's like, hey, don't do that. Johnny, you remember them old days when we first get started? Man, isn't it fun, man? It's fun now. It's a blast now. But you just remember. I remember him saying, he's like, hey, you got it. We make that move. You can't be doing it over there. They're going to be in there. You can't be in there. It's like, oh! You know? I love it, man. It's so fun.
It wasn't that funny, Elizabeth Mosley. It wasn't that funny.
What's she talking about?
She's talking about sign. Church signs.
She's talking about that church sign.
Well, give me the background on this. I forget too easily. What was it said? You said it's... What did it say?
I said, he is divine.
He is divine.
D-E-V-I-N-E.
Yeah, like divine. Like
D-E-V, yes.
Like, we are the branches.
What was it supposed to say?
That's what branches? It says, but it's making... Let's speak...
The Bible says he is the vine. We are the branches.
Okay.
But he was saying divine, like, because he's the
vine. Was that meant to be funny?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. That's still funny. When you had to print, I had to get you to, yeah. to, because I'm not that savvy. I was like, okay, but yeah, that's pretty funny. The branches.
It's better than like, you think it's hot outside. Wait till you
get yeah.
Yeah, really.
It's better than something like that.
I'm having way too much fun with my
you
phone.
You are having
camera.
A lot of fun.
But I feel like it's giving on. They always see this view of us.
Yeah.
Like what does Corey's the left side of Corey's head look like? Well, now you know.
I'd like that you do that because it's obviously this is mine's delayed. Whoa. Okay, I was gonna say some of the little smiley, laughy faces are caught up on the thing.
You want what?
I want to see what it looks like when you're
in this. Not your puppet, Joel. All right. I'm gonna do it just for
Elizabeth
Joel.
Put it up there.
Watch. I see. Okay. I would have thought it would have been spelled with an E, but yeah, I see it's with an I.
This is for Joel. All right, because Joel has never seen the left side of Corey's face. Never. There you go.
Check out the part though.
That is a beautiful part.
It's up there.
That's wonderful.
And look, I need to, it's about time down. For another cut.
Look at that part. That's a John, good
Jerry nice said you were on fire yesterday.
Did you get fired up, John?
Fire!
Did you get
fired? Did you have to stop in the middle of the service and go? I don't.
Did you see that, Joe?
Man, I didn't have a chance to watch it.
Oh man,
I try to watch the live streams of all of our churches. You know,
that's,
like,
do you hear me laughing?
Like
that live?
Yeah,
Faith Assembly.
I do. I mean, I'm all right with it. It's just
Unity.
Can you tell actually who's doing that? Because somebody just sitting there hammered.
Yeah, that's what happens.
Somebody does it.
That's Donna Crabtree. Yeah,
that's so cool to me, though.
What?
You have, like, the rooftop view.
I know, yeah. We could stick this camera anywhere.
Even if that is just one person, for the fact that somebody is sitting there doing that because they love the show so much, it's pretty cool. Just going to flood of emojis and thumbs ups.
Yeah.
Here you go. Do a plea. Do a plea for them right now.
Please, yeah. I would really enjoy it if you would just give us a whole bunch of loves right now. Just give us all the loves you can get for 10 seconds straight.
Hey, give us
And hey, I love it because...
Come on, Corey. Give us one of these.
Give us some of that. Hey, you know, if you want to see a Fredgy Sanford moment, you said... Oh, here it comes. Look, they're doing it. They're doing it. Look at that. Oh, Lord, I feel a love. I feel a love up in here. Oh, it's wonderful. Y'all, look at that. Oh, man. Oh, I can't take it.
Now I'm
can't
gonna,
take no more.
I'm gonna bust your heart.
Y'all are awesome, man.
I've never watched Sanford and Sons.
What? I don't think I ever have either.
What?
Really, I really haven't
never,
either.
Have you?
Yeah.
I didn't ever watch it
it's
growing
funny,
up.
Man.
But it's one of those things, you know who it, you know
it's
what it
just,
is.
It's funny.
Yeah.
Like the old man is funny, dude.
Yeah.
End of story.
Yeah.
Funny.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna what have to that? Start watching.
I mean, y'all.
What's going on over there?
What's going on?
8:25
Hey, did you see that story
morning?
I put in there about the dad who? So there's this.
The heartbeat.
Yes, there's six month old girl in the hospital.
Right.
And she's got she was diagnosed at 4 months with this rare disease.
Mm-hmm.
And the disease really it keeps her from being able to move her muscles.
Mm-hmm.
And so the dad stays in the hospital with her all the time. Him and the mom switch out. So he was leaving her the other day, and went like this. Like, to signify our heartbeat, like, no matter where I go, you're always with me. I mean, I see baseball players do this all the time. Basketball, football players do it like this all the time. So he went like this, and this six-month-old girl brings her arm up and does this right back to him.
Isn't that amazing?
And so the doctors, like, mom got it on video. The mom said that they had specifically prayed that morning for that they would see signs of movement,
uh-huh.
muscle movement in her, and they had prayed specifically over her arms.
All right, yeah. Hold on.
And that's
working. Everything should be working.
So she
test. Yeah. See, Norman, can you hear? Because Norman says yes. Donna Crabtree says no. I am right now. I had to switch it up for a second.
What?
Now I'm back on Yeti. Can y'all hear, or is it just some people? And that's weird. If not. Jessica Lemon has sound.
I have sound.
But some people don't. Like, I don't have sound, but some people do.
Corey Tripp
Corey
says
doesn't.
Audio
How?
Gone.
So that's a Facebook thing.
Norman Kirk says both. He has sound. And
so him and his wife have sound. So that's Facebook. Do y'all have sound?
Jessica
Lemon has sound.
I have sound. Mine is loading.
I don't have sound.
Scott Johnson has it. Carol Rose has it.
I have sound.
My video is froze. Jessica Lemon.
That is very weird.
Very weird.
It's
hopefully
back
y'all
on.
Heard me and Corey tell this story about this
that
girl,
is,
dad. Heartbeat, really good stuff.
And now
I think
it's hey,
maybe
restart,
it's back.
And she ain't gonna be able to see it. Type in there, restart your Facebook. It was Facebook. That was very weird for us.
Got sound back.
You got it.
Says Donna Crabtree.
Yeah, I guess if you ever lose sound, just restart Facebook. It's crazy. Facebook trying to throttle our views. We said, not today, Facebook. Not today, Satan.
Come
get up
on,
out of
somebody.
Here. All right. That was weird. Sorry, continue with that story because they didn't hear it unless they're good lip readers. Not alone.
Hey,
Rudy's here. Rudy is just chilling in here. Yes, I like he that.
Yes, he is.
Dental school.
He loves our show, man.
Dental school. I was talking to Nikki Davis via Facebook this weekend, and that's how I knew she'd been gone for so long. She's like, my days have just been so crazy.
Mm-hmm.
There's a switch up. I don't know if maybe in taking dropping off her son or something. Anyway, but she's like, man, I really miss you guys. And I was like, really? She lives in Nashville, man. She just likes hopping on and
I love
starting
it.
Her day with us.
I love it that people, you know, good stuff. They get something out of it. That's the biggest thing. You, what was I about to ask you? Oh, yeah. T-shirts. What's up with them?
Yes.
The order has been placed. Has it not?
The order. The order has the been Lord placed. Has been placed. No, yeah.
I so I was that like, too.
The Lord
that
has
too. Been placed. Both
of them. I'm not as strong as you are.
No, yeah. So he's talking about Rudy. Rudy loves a good high five.
Rudy does.
Okay,
and I have small hands, and there's not a lot of padding up in here.
That was a great high five.
It was, man. But Rudy, if you're listening, I love giving him a high five, but I can't stand it because a man ain't gonna back down.
Right.
He's gonna be like, yeah, let's do it. Come on. And then I'll do it. I'm like, ah.
Yeah, mine's burning.
Ah! Yeah, you just
kind of burning over here. Like my hands all red.
And then
I ain't letting it sweat.
If it's not a good one, he's like, oh man, no, that wasn't
good. Oh, it's
got to
be a perfect.
We got to do it again. Yeah. And then I'm like, dude, yeah, it was fine, bro. What you want to do it again? You know,
but you
it's
can't.
Funny.
A man cannot turn down a
high. Can't turn it down.
This dude could be holding 17 hypodermic needles in his hand like this, and if he holds up the high five symbol. You're giving them a high five. A guy is not going to turn down a high five, I feel.
I'm going to turn that high five down.
Yeah, I probably would too.
I'm going to settle for elbow rub.
Amen. Get them
whatever, then. You're not
get
real
get,
men.
Get them needles out your hands and we high five.
So you
shirt
said,
order.
Shirts,
yes.
Yeah.
So the artist, the order has been sent. The artist has to render the logo, which should be done today.
Right.
Once we approve the logo, then they start making the shirts.
Yeah. We have a timeline, like maybe a week or two.
They told us it's a week and a half total turnaround from when we gave it to them, which was last week. So I would say 2 weeks because
2 weeks.
I hadn't got the rendering.
Did you see what he said? Rudy said, toughen up them baby mitts, buddy. Rudy, listen, the Lord bless me with semi-medium hands. Like, they're not very big. So, a funny story about Deani and I. We have the same size hands. No joke. My hands are that small. I don't have big hands. So, that's not me saying my girl has big hands. That's me saying I have tiny hands. I've only met, like, one dude that has hands that are smaller than mine. I'm not going to say his name. You probably know him, though. He works at the police department. But he's got hands smaller than me, and I was amazed.
Donald Trump has small hands.
Does he?
Does he?
I didn't know that.
I've seen memes going around about him. I don't know that I've ever looked at his hands.
No, it's funny, man. Like, it's weird. Like, Deanna and I, we have the same blood type. We have the same type of birthmark on our foot. It's pretty strange. Yeah.
Really?
It's kind of.
Y'all are just like, God knitted you together.
I believe so. Yeah.
But in their mother's womb.
Mother's womb.
God did them both at the same time. He knitted one of you with his right hand and one of you with his left hand.
It's weird.
Crocheting Corey and Deani at the same time.
I'm telling you. But yeah, no. I did.
Oh, yeah. First week back to school.
I like my tiny hands.
Can I see your birthmark on your foot?
Yeah.
Are you wearing flip-flops?
I don't see. No, I'm wearing shoes.
Oh, don't
worry.
Here's
the thing. No, it's not in the exact same place, but it's just one of those.
Style.
It's the same type. You know how you have, like, I don't know if you. Birthmarks, some of them are just red. It's a red spot on my foot. And she's got, like, the same thing going on. I'm like. So,
that's awesome, actually.
You know, yeah, it is. It is pretty cool.
Jessica Lemon. First week back to school for the kids. Also, regular routine starts back for my daycare babies. And the husband left for 2 weeks of training.
Yeah, so not much, huh?
Yeah. Starbucks delivery and prayers appreciated.
We got you.
Hey.
Jessica
Lemon. By the way, love that new profile picture of yours and your husband. That's pretty beautiful. I like that. Somebody had to notice that besides me. Look at that beautiful picture.
I did. It's very large.
I spoke to her husband last week, and I think he's got 2 weeks of training.
Aaron.
Hope he has a great 2 weeks. He's going to driver's instructor school.
driver instructor school?
Yep. Mm-hmm. So they can be a driver's training instructor.
Sure, sure.
Cool. Teach in service for the department and stuff like that.
Very teach cool. people how to drive fast.
So it's a tough school, from what I've heard.
So he's learning all like the slides and the drifts. And
the electric slide.
He's
going
to go do all that fun stuff. Me?
California drift.
I
wouldn't
do it.
Yeah, true story.
California drift.
Mm-hmm. Yes, indeed.
Man.
Very cool. That's awesomeness.
I love the devotion for today.
In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Yeah, there are times.
I love it, man.
There are times.
I feel like God wants me to go to the altar.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't. I don't know why. Sometimes, obviously, I know why.
Speak on that.
But there are times where I feel like God wants me to go to the altar.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just not sure why. And I'll go, and as soon as I hit the altar, it's just like a wave of just weeping or crying, you know. I think if you're in church, you call it weeping. If you're out of church, you call it crying. But just the wave of that. And I have no idea.
Yeah.
None. What I'm there for.
Yeah.
I just know that I'm supposed to be there.
Yeah.
And I think that attests some to what Miss Donna was saying when it's, that feeling of I don't know.
There's a lot happening in that.
Well,
there's a lot going on in that. There's being yourself of yourself.
Yeah.
And you're saying I couldn't care what anybody else thinks.
Right.
Maybe they think I've done the worst thing this week, and I really don't care. Yeah. I need Jesus. Yeah. And at that moment, you're just proclaiming that not only is it you going to an altar to talk to Jesus, but you're proclaiming, I need Jesus.
Yeah. Because we all
just do. Like every single person.
Because we all do. Because we all have baggage. You know what I mean?
I love it when you hit a good topic, man. Because I don't get these often, but I've gotten them.
Chili's.
Wait. Chili's. More. Y'all are getting really good at these high fives today. I think we need to settle with
that. That was flush.
That was. That wasn't. That didn't hurt.
Shout out to Johnny knows about that flush high five. That fluid flush high five.
Scott Johnson said that's the spirit moving in you, brother.
Yeah.
Yep.
It is, and that's Jesus. That's the power of, And but sometimes I like I'll that. Go and just say Jesus.
It's like, funny. I feel like you can be saved, and you'll always have that. You're mm-hmm. always gonna be like, I don't know why, but I need to go. And you know what I mean? And then you'll have that. It's just. I think that's what's one of the many beautiful things about this life is there's always something you can just take to the altar.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? I love it. I love it. And just say Jesus.
Just say Jesus.
And we get to do it for all eternity. I wonder if we can have a radio station in heaven. Wouldn't that be cool?
I'm just going to do a quick
one. We're on segment, the second segment.
Second?
Second seven.
Yep.
Don't do that. Oh, we about to go on, man.
So it's the verses in the...
Y'all can't
do
that.
So we are helping you get those kids back to school.
Yes.
This morning. Today is the first day of school after that spring break.
Man.
And we are helping you decompress here on 98.3 The Bridge. We're having... great time.
I feel like Jesus will be called on this morning with what
I feel
you just
like
described.
Jesus will be
there's
going to
be some people stuck in traffic, man. And I feel like there's going to be some moms.
That's funny.
And there's going to be somebody's going to be hollering out the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Quieting them kids down and trying to beat that traffic. I feel for you. I don't know what you're going through, but I feel for you. Lord have mercy. Bless you.
So the JOD.
Yes.
Devotion for today, man. That the verse is just
he delivers
on time.
Again, man. And I tell you, man, it's powerful because people are, and they always do it, but like I said, they relate to this. They love these devotionals, and I love it when people, like Jerry just had a beautiful description of how he's impacted when he's worshiping. And sometimes we don't fully know, like we just have this feeling, and
right.
It's just the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
And we just feel like, I don't know what I need to profess, proclaim, confess. I don't know, but I just need to go.
Yeah.
And I feel like that's the same thing that's going on when we don't know what to pray, like Donna Crabtree was saying, or we don't know the words. We don't. But, and that's what I was talking about earlier, we serve a God that even when we don't know the words, when we can't make the words of what we need, we don't even really know what we need sometimes, man.
Right.
Yeah.
But the Lord intercedes, just like she said, and the Lord knows for us. All we have to do is call out his name.
Yes.
And I love that.
Yeah.
That's beautiful, man.
That's beautiful.
It's comforting.
Yeah.
It really is. And yes, Brandon Nicholson, he did a wonderful job, man. the topic for today, in Jesus' name, is what we're calling it. And here we go. Matthew 18:20. For where two or three gather in my name, there am I with them.
Yeah.
And I mean, it's just, I'm telling you, it's just adding on to it. I mean, you know, you yourself can call on Jesus, but then when two or three or four of us or 10 of us or 20, the number goes on and on.
Right.
Powerful.
You know, it's so powerful. Yes. It really is.
And I love, you know, Johnny's told me a lot since I've been here, as he talks about being in agreement in prayer, you know, and when we're, I mean, Christ is always with us, right?
Yes.
You know, he's, as a Christian, he lives inside of us.
Yep.
But it's a different type when you're together with other brothers and sisters in Christ. And when you're coming together in agreement over a prayer need or over something going on in your life, and to know that beyond a shadow of a doubt that you're gathering here because of a need or because of a want or because or to praise, and you know Jesus is right here.
Yes.
That's awesome.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, agreement, man. Agreement is a powerful word. Agreement. He said, if any two on earth agree as touching anything.
Yeah.
And that is powerful. You know what I think we've done, though, in the church world is we've put limits on the name of Jesus. Mm. We've gotten really into our traditions and our religious flows, and we've put a lot of limits on the name of Jesus. Mm-hmm. You know, like this show is called Beyond Limits. Mm-hmm. Like, do we really believe that the name of Jesus is beyond limits?
That's
do we really yeah. believe that the same power that Jesus walked in 2,000 years ago on the earth, that he's still capable of walking in today? And here's right. how he's going to do it today. He's going to do it through you and me.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
As we use his name,
yeah.
that power goes first. And see, that was a norm for the early church. But we've just through the years, we've just limited the name of Jesus. As I was talking at last segment, if the lottery winner believes they can win the lottery and win it and just like blow all these different odds of what it takes to win it, how much more can you and I believe in the power of the name of Jesus and believe that we were saved? I just believe if I pray with you. Now, I just believe that if we pray together that God's going to do that.
Yep.
Now, does it happen exactly how I believe every time? No, not necessarily. But that's not my deal. That's not my job.
Uh-huh.
Listen, I'm called a believer. What do believers do? We believe, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
So if we just believe in the name,
yep.
I think that's the key, man, is not take the limits off of the name of Jesus and believe in the power of the name of Jesus.
Man. How you just going to come in here and drop bombs like that, man? Mm,
Jesus, man.
Jesus, I love it, man.
He's the bomb.
That's good. That's an interesting concept. I love that. Got one more segment coming up. Boy, it is lit up in here. We love you guys so much. Stay with us. More positive music coming your way.
Do this song right here, y'all. There's power in the name of Jesus.
Come on, somebody.
Hey, there's another song.
Did you do that on purpose?
Yeah. There's another one called
Power.
Y'all want to hear what we're listening to? Hey, crank the headsets
up. Crank the headphones up.
Power in the name of Jesus.
I like
break
it loud,
every
too.
Chain. Break every chain.
There's another one out there.
Break
I was just singing it while I was singing it.
You talking about another artist that sings
another
it?
Another song. A different song
yeah.
I sang it. Yeah. What was it?
So you talking about a different song?
Yeah, there's another song, a different one about in Jesus' name.
Love this song.
This is the one I think of, but I'm trying to figure out what you're talking about.
There's another one. I sang a little bit of it. You know, I got it. No, there's another one. And this is one I'm going to get. There's another one. I'll get you back in the next segment.
Woo! Who's the rest of me?
This song is lovely.
Lovely, beautiful, gorgeous.
Can I just sit here and listen?
That's what they're doing. They're listening. It's great. I got it up there. It's great.
Just say Jesus. You don't know what to say. Just say Jesus. Remember, I'm going to
Come on. Come on. Come on. Hey. Damn. Come on. I woke up yesterday morning and had some song stuck in my mind. I can't remember what it was.
Good job, Joel.
Good job, Joel.
Indeed.
You did it.
You did it, Joel.
You did it, Joel.
It's Joel Money.
Good job, Joel Money.
It's Joel Money up in here.
Woo! So, yeah. Are any of y'all in school? Y'all going to college like, I don't know. Clearly you're not in high school because you're watching us, and well, some people do watch us from high school, like Jared, Ryan. But are any of y'all in college right now? I know Justin Mosley is. And if so, it's the end of the semester, man.
Yes.
End of the semester. Great week. Mama D, you have a great week.
Yes, have a good week and a good work day. Brandon Scott Murphy and Mama D. Joel Carol Rose says she loves you.
We love Joel. Carol Rose says we love Joel. Randomly.
Joel Money!
I think I was talking about you fading that song out. So I got two tests to take today. Let's do tonight. Really not looking forward to either one of them either.
Well, watch out now. Everybody look out.
Tell you what though, I graduate next Friday.
Aren't you excited?
I am excited.
Should be.
Liberty University.
Ooh, Lord. Man.
Welcome back, Corey.
I ain't had time to go to the store.
Corey Fallow.
I ain't had time to go to the store. Nothing.
I haven't
even unpacked
yet.
Have you not?
My husband and daughter are both finishing up college semesters this week. Where do they go to college at, Carol?
Yes.
It's Brock. It is a lot. Like, I can't wait.
I don't know, man.
I can't.
I told you, I had aspirations to go back. I don't know if that's ever.
NBA?
Yeah, but I don't know if that's going to happen or not. I don't know. We'll see.
Woo! It's rough. There's been a lot of late nights when the kids are asleep. Normally, I'll just stay out at the church. So I work at Temple Church, and normally I'll just stay out there until I'm done.
Yeah.
They got a pretty good Wi-Fi system out there. I plug straight in, so I don't have to worry about the Wi-Fi going out in the middle of a test. I took a test this semester. That at the end of it, I clicked submit, and it said, must log in first. Like, none of the tests recorded. But what did record was the time limit. So I had 45 minutes to start. Then I had 10 minutes left to retake the entire test. Bruh, yeah.
Did you get it?
Yeah, because I remembered the answers. When I saw them, it was 25 questions. So I remembered the answers, and I was like, you know, it wasn't as bad. But, yeah, I did get it. That's rough, man.
Thomas Lovett wants to know, are you going to walk in Lynchburg?
Absolutely.
Yes, he
is. Mike Pence is speaking, Thomas.
I would.
I am.
Absolutely.
We got a hotel room.
Oh!
Like 45 minutes away.
Oh!
Oh.
I don't know. And Carol Rose said, husband is at Beaufort County Community College, daughter's at UNC.
Corey, tell me about this event you got coming up on Saturday.
Man, you know, I'm excited about it.
Is it like a Spartan race?
So this is the deal. I signed up for this with Deani in November of last year. So she reminded me just like last week about it because I'd forgotten about it. Obviously, it was like, 6 months ago I signed up for it pretty much. So it's in Petersburg. It's a Rugged Maniac. And we did one in Virginia Beach, I think. October of last year.
Okay.
October, November of last year. So after we got done with that one, her friend wanted to do another one, which was this weekend. So we decided we'd go ahead and sign up for it in advance. So all it is an obstacle race. It's kind of like a Tough Mudder Spartan race. It's just a little bit dumbed down, meaning like it's not as far. But they do have some pretty cool obstacles. I'm really excited about it. I did enjoy it. I had a good time at the last one. You can walk it.
God is good.
But I don't know.
Sorry.
I don't know. We might try to. We stick together. It's like me and Paul. Like, I'm not going to leave her, so we're going to go throughout the whole thing. But you do get a little muddy. And at the end, at the last one we did at the end, they had a big old pool, muddy, dirty water, and you had to go across the monkey bars and you slip and fall in there. But I didn't fall in that. I'm going to try not to do it in this one either.
What one is it that they had the electric
wire? Dude, that's like
electric wire.
Is that a Spartan or it's
no,
Spartan?
This is called a Rugged Maniac.
Have you seen the one I'm talking about?
I haven't seen the electric wires.
Like, you got a low crawl underneath of electric. What is that?
I think it's a tough. It's either a Tough Mudder or a Spartan.
Yeah. It's one of them.
Yeah. There's one where you get electrocuted.
There is no point in any of our runs where I've said, I'd rather be getting electrocuted right now.
But I've seen in other ones where they have, like, some of that stuff is kind of, like in, I think in the Tough Mudder, they have, like, ice water.
Yeah.
I'm just like.
Yes.
See, I can get down with maybe the muddiness, and that, but that's about as far as I'm willing
to go.
It's
like a dumpster. It's like a big tin. Like a
yeah, that's about as far as I'm willing to go. I'm not trying to catch hypothermia. You know what I'm saying? I'm being serious. I mean,
yeah, me too, man.
You
got to
think, the Tough Mudders are like 13 miles long, man. So it's just like a half marathon.
Yeah.
So you're not like, you know, you're jogging and trotting, but you're also walking a lot of it,
mm-hmm.
and because you got to save energy for the obstacles. A lot of what is in this Rugged Maniac is walls to climb over, and then they've got like monkey bars and some other like gripping things you got to climb across, and it's fun. Some I could do like 90% of it. There was like two things that I could not do. I think I can do it this time. I think I found the answer to it. It's just, we talked about earlier, I have small hands, so there's some things you have to like. Yeah, they have like little metal. They have like metal.
Which hand are we going
that's
with?
The one you
We're
want.
Going with this hand.
Yeah. See, Paul ain't got big hands.
I don't have big hands.
But you can see, he's clearly got like half an inch on each one of my fingers.
We did it.
Oh, but you know what I mean? So I'm trying to, you got to like grip.
I feel like, put y'all's hands together.
That's how it would be.
Well, our hands were the same.
Wow, yeah. His hand is a little bigger than mine.
I now pronounce you.
But yours was
co-host.
Just a little. But you gotta like one of
Bush?
Them. You gotta like grab like a little metal ball,
yeah,
and that you swing from that to
like
another. So it's
yeah.
hard to grip. It's very. I don't have the best grip strength, you know, but I think I can get it this time. I practiced a little bit.
Have y'all ever done Tough Mudders?
Rugged Maniac.
You want to?
They're fun though, man.
45 seconds.
They're very fun.
Hey, I think we're gonna go back on the radio. Why not?
Hey,
let's do that.
Let's do it.
Let's do that whole radio thing.
Let's do it too.
Let's have fun.
Ain't nothing to it, but we got up against a heartbreak.
You're
a heartbreaker.
Hey, man, this is the last segment. We love you guys. Have y'all ever done Tough Mudders, or do we got any marathon runners or anything like that?
Yeah.
Let us know.
Tough Mudder, baby.
Yay. Man, you guys are awesome. Danny Button. Danny Button's on.
Hey, Danny
Button.
Whoa. He's being serious right now, Danny Button.
What's up?
It's time to be serious.
You be serious because you got to open.
That at the name of Jesus, every that's exclusive. Every knee will bow.
Yes.
Every tongue will confess that He is Lord.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Nah, yeah.
That's.
Getting real, man. I'm gonna tell you, I love this.
Give you goosebumps, bro.
It will give you goosebumps.
There's
people that say, "I, you know, he don't exist." And well, you know, okay.
Feel sorry for him, man.
This has already been addressed. This has already been decided. And one day, every knee is gonna bow. Every tongue is gonna confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Yeah.
It's not any better than that.
You know,
it doesn't.
We were talking about it earlier about how we don't have the words and how God just still is there for us. And
yes.
I just love that. I can't really get over that this morning because I feel that. I feel like I feel that. Every other day, if not every day.
Yeah.
There's some point in everybody's day where they're just sitting back. And it could be positive, man. Like I said earlier, you could be just so, like, blessed. And you could just feel so good. I'm like, man, I don't know how to say thank you.
Yeah.
Right. But then you just say thank you, Jesus. And then you realize, like, hey, that's enough. You know, I mean, and you can't stop. And that's the way it is. That's the way it should be. And I just pray that everybody can, you know, experience that.
Yeah.
Because there's just no better feeling. I mean,
There are times in my, I try to set aside
specific times during my devotions, like not every day, but at least, you know, once every week or two, where I just take 5 minutes and I don't do anything other than just say the name of Jesus.
Yes.
You know, and that's such a powerful time, because there really is. I mean, we're not making this up.
Yeah.
There really is power in the name of Jesus.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
And just speaking the name of Jesus out loud, there's power in that, and you can just feel it. It's really cool. It's a really one of my favorite times of my devotions.
Yeah. What about when you're in church? And I don't know how this works for you, Johnny, because you're the one giving the word most of the time. But like when you feel like the pastor he spoke a word and it clicks. She's like, oh yeah, man, I needed that right there. Yeah. And that you drop the Jesus right then, like Jesus, you know, because you just feel like that was meant for you, you know. And I felt that yesterday. And I feel it all the time. And then sometimes you could just be going about your day, man, and then something happened. You have an interaction with somebody. Something just happens, and you just feel like that was a God moment.
Right.
You know what I mean? I feel like that. I mean, there's just so many examples to give when you call on the name of Jesus, mm-hmm, through praise or when you just straight up need him.
Yeah.
You know what
the
I mean?
Name Jesus, within the name Jesus, is the power to save.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
You know, I think about what you guys were talking about earlier. There have been people that just before their last breath, the only word they said was Jesus.
Yeah.
And that was it. Yeah. They crossed this, you know, they crossed that river and they were right there with him in that moment. Maybe they never acknowledged him prior to, but in that moment they said Jesus.
Yeah.
And that was it. You know, one of my favorite Bible teachers, his grandfather, just right on his deathbed, received Jesus,
mm-hmm,
and the power in the name of Jesus. But think about this name Jesus. What does Jesus mean? What does the name Jesus mean? If you remember, Joshua,
yep,
had the same name as Jesus. It is Yeshua in the Hebrew. And here's what Yeshua means. Yeshua means Jehovah is salvation.
Yep.
Jehovah is salvation, or Jehovah saves. And this word save and salvation come from the Greek word sozo and soteria.
All right,
the word sozo means, it's the Greek word. Every time you see the word saved in the New Testament,
yep,
it is the Greek word sozo. When you see this word salvation, it's the Greek word soteria. Here's what it means. It means to be saved, healed, delivered, preserved, protected, to be made prosperous, and to be made whole.
Yes.
And so people get tripped out when they hear that word prosperous, but that word prosperous means to be fully supplied, in need or want of nothing. And need a one on us. So think about this now. The name of Jesus has the power to save us from our sins.
Yep.
But in the name of Jesus is our healing.
Yeah.
Jesus is our healing. Jesus is our provision. Jesus is our protection. Mm-hmm. Jesus is our wholeness, our provision. In Jesus is everything we need.
Yes.
So when you say Jesus, you're saying a lot.
Uh-huh.
You're saying a lot.
You are. Yeah. And that's why it's so powerful. And there have been times, you know, going back to what you were saying, Corey, in church. So before Paul was our youth pastor, and Paul does our announcements. I would do our announcements. Mm-hmm. And there were times where it was just a really powerful moment of worship.
Yeah.
And I can remember getting up there and just saying, you know what, guys, let's just close our eyes and let's just say Jesus, mm-hmm, together as a congregation.
Yeah.
And man, just to feel the Holy Spirit move like that, it's just really awesome, and to know that power is available to you,
yeah,
at any point,
yes,
during your day.
I love that. I love
that. Awesome.
That's good. What a wonderful topic. JLD, Jesus loving dentist, writes our devotions. He is he owns the Kinston Dental Associates in Kinston. He did a phenomenal job today, and no matter what you're going through today, no matter where you're at, maybe you're having an awesome day at the top of a mountain somewhere and you just got some really good news, praise Jesus.
Yep.
Maybe you're in the bottom of a valley, pray to Jesus.
That's right.
No matter where you're at, no matter what you're doing, just say the name of Jesus today. Take a moment, concentrate on him, and focus, put your focus on him today. Man, mm-hmm, what a wonderful thought.
Awesome. Indeed. Thank you for listening. Y'all are the best listeners here on 98.3 The Bridge.
Man, you guys are awesome.
This one?
Yeah.
The one that you were talking about earlier?
Yeah. Y'all heard that live.
Just say Jesus.
Y'all heard that live on the waterfront.
Norman Kirk.
Norman Kirk says, I thought today was Monday, not Sunday.
Preach, brother, preach. Indeed. Dropping it in here. You don't know what to say.
Jesus. Oh, that worked out perfectly.
Whoa!
Good job, Joel.
That's why I had tongues.
There was a lot going on. I was like, are we out of time? Or I didn't. Man, 17 people. Prayer request. Get those last minute prayer requests.
Get them in.
So we can pray.
You need to mention them.
You know what?
We got to go to
Washington.
Do you have
a prayer list?
Yep.
Put school.
Frankie G's fever has gone down, so they will proceed with his triple bypass tomorrow. Prayers, please.
All those in school.
Got you, Jessica Lemon. You see the update she put up there?
Yep.
Good stuff right there.
Hey, that's a cool family. Their whole family is cool.
Yeah.
I like that. Thank you. We got a chance to meet him. That's a really good family.
You're listening to WLGT.
Washington Grayville.
98.3 The Bridge.
So yeah, I love that. Scott Johnson.
Hey, this is James with Pet Supplies Plus and Grand.
What's up, brother? Y'all have prayer requests? You got anything? We're about to pray with y'all.
Yes.
So if you got a prayer request, something you're going through, or you maybe a praise, something awesome happening, let us know.
Praise and worship. Dun dun dun.
Lucia Davenport.
You know, okay, yeah, I went by to see her, Stacy, the other day. She was asleep, and I think your mom and them were somewhere. I don't know, but I went in there. If she'd woke up, she'd probably been a little freaked out because just a random dude in there. But yeah. Please continue to pray for Donald Fripp's Crabtree, Unspoken. Cool, gotcha, yes. I wonder if it's supposed to be a beautiful week.
Yes.
It's supposed to be a very good week.
Yes.
Are you on nights or days?
I'm on nights, but I think I'm going to not be working. Like I have Saturday off. I'm supposed to teach at the college Wednesday and Thursday and Friday from 8 to 5. So I don't know how I'm going to work that. I'm going to have to see. Because I can't be working too late Friday because I have to be up. The run's not until 10:15, but still, I got to sit down and like literally plan it out. I don't know how I'm going to do it. I might have to go in
tomorrow.
And
you'll be here every day this week though, right?
Yes. Oh yeah. I will.
Back-to-back weeks, baby.
I'm telling you, man. It's wonderful. All
right. Cool. Good. I got him.
Yes.
Then roll with it. All right, guys. Hey, we're going to pray. And like always, I keep monitoring. So if you got a prayer request, you're just hopping on and you got a prayer request while we're praying. We'll catch it up there. And so, throw it down there. You got a praise item. Throw it in the comment section. All right. Talk to God.
Ready?
Let's do it.
Let's get it.
Yep. Let's go. Lord Jesus, thank you for the opportunity to gather here. And Lord, more importantly than that, thank you for gathering with us. And God, as we talked about this morning, we know that you're here. That your word says where two or three are gathered, that you are in our midst. And we thank you for being here in our midst this morning. God, we bring these requests before you. We think of Rachel Fight, who needs a new mobility scooter. God, we pray that you would provide for her. We pray that you would move, even if it be in a miraculous way there, and to help her be able to get that scooter. Lord, for Miss Bonnie Yaw, who is having issues with her heart and her leg, I pray that you would be with the doctors as they move forward. Help them to diagnose in the plan of treatment to be the best thing for her. For Norman Kirk, as he's battling a bug right now, God, I pray that you would help him to feel better quickly. Lord, for Jessica Lemon, I ask that you would just be with her as she's got a crazy couple of weeks coming up with her husband being gone, the kids being back in school, just a lot going on. I pray that you would help her to find her rest and to find her peace in you during this time. Lord, for school, as there's a bunch of kids starting back from spring break. Lord, our college students, I think specifically of Paul, who's finishing up, getting ready to graduate. God, I pray that you would give them the strength to finish strong over the next
few days. For Frankie G, who's having triple bypass surgery tomorrow, God, I pray that you would just each movement, each thought, Lord, each surgery, each move would be ordained by you. Lord, that you would go, that you would be with him in that surgery, be with his family. Lord, his daughter, Marion, who's also having some kidney issues right now, I pray that you would be with her as well. For Lucia Davenport, God, I pray that you would meet her needs, that you would be with her during this time, Lord. And for Miss Donna, she has this unspoken prayer need. I pray that, Lord, you would meet that. You know what that is, and I pray that you would meet it as only you can meet it. God, thank you for meeting with us this morning. But I'm going to let one of my other brothers finish this out. I love you, and I thank you for all that you do.
Lord, thank you, Lord, for an awesome show today, a show where we can proclaim your name across Eastern North Carolina, across our Facebook family, so it's going out to different countries, Lord. Your word says that every knee is going to bow, every tongue is going to confess, Lord. And we are so humbly grateful for the abilities that you've given us to do that right now. And we don't take that for granted. We love you so much, Lord. I pray, Lord, for Jeremy Smith. He's got several friends who are taking exams today, going back to school. Lord, I just pray, Lord, you'll be with them, Lord. Jeremy himself is in school. So the light at the end of the tunnel phrase seems to work really well right now, Lord. But help us to strive and just run our Christian race, Lord, with endurance. And similarly, run our educational race with endurance, Lord, so we can see that finish line coming and just strive, Lord, and get it done, Lord, in your name. And I thank you, Lord. I thank you for the show. I thank you for the friendship that I have with Corey and with Jared and Johnny and Joel, Lord, and what we're able to do here as a team, Lord. Lift your name above all things, Lord. And we love you so much, Lord. We don't take any of this for granted, Lord, for I ask all this in Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord, we just thank you so much for everything that you're doing, everything you've done, and everything that you're going to do, Lord. We thank you for the platform to reach people, and we thank you for our viewers and our listeners, Lord, as they are able to come to us, and it's humbling, Lord, to sit here and have people want to give us prayer requests, Lord, to bring to you with them. And it just goes to show you the focus for today was in Jesus' name, Lord, and when two or three gather in your name, Lord, and that's what we have. We have literally sometimes 20, 30, 40, 50, there may be people we don't even know about, Lord, and they're watching and attending this show and listening on the radio, Lord, because they have genuine needs, they have a hunger for you, and they need you in their life, Lord. And we pray that those that don't know you, if it is your will and they should find you through this show, Lord, what an honor it would be, Lord. And whatever your will is, let it be done. If that's not for us, Lord, then we understand. We just pray that they find you no matter what, Jesus. And we love you, Lord, and we thank you just for all the prayer requests, Lord, all the unspoken prayer requests that have been coming. And we just pray that the needs would be met, Lord, if it is according to your will. And we just thank you, Jesus, Lord, just for everything you do and everything that you're going to do, Lord. It's just so amazing to sit here in your presence, Lord, and just be with brothers and sisters in Christ, Lord. And it just feels so wonderful. And I thank you so much for the opportunity. Thank you for life. Just thank you for all that you've done. In Jesus Christ's holy and precious name.
Father, we just bless you. We praise you. We just magnify your holy name today, Father. As we just move forward, Father, help us to keep you as our focus, Father. Help us to stay in your flow, not to get to the right or to the left, but just stay right in your flow, knowing that you want to do something really cool, really amazing in this region. Through this show, that you want to reach hundreds, even thousands of people with your good news, that you want to help get people's joy back in them, Father. Those that are struggling, maybe they're going through some tough things, and you want this to be a ray of hope. So, Father, help us to flow with you in all we do. And we thank you, we praise you, we ask for your divine protection over ourselves, our families, our stuff. Father, meet every need. We just come to you in the name of Jesus for every one of these requests, believing that we receive as we have prayed, and we give you glory for it all. In Jesus' name, amen.
Now, what I like one of the best things that I like is that the viewers that were on at the beginning of the prayer are still on.
Yep.
I mean, they're praying with us.
Yep.
And that is good. Cool. This is so much more than a show. This
absolutely
is so much more than a show to us, and we hope it is to y'all.
Praise
it is,
the Lord.
It's
man.
Just a big, big old fat family. Love it.
Family.
Just growing, growing, growing every day. Y'all are awesome, man.
Yes.
We don't take this for granted. We don't take y'all clicking that log on button for granted. We truly don't. And we hope that every Monday through Friday when we show up, we are giving y'all the absolute best that we have to give because God requires that of us.
Yes.
He wants us to show up and praise His name with everything we have.
Yeah.
Yes. And if we're going to
joy, show, laughter, jokes,
yes,
devotion, whatever that is.
Yeah.
Yep.
Just we have a risen Savior, Lord, that we get to worship, you know. And some days are going to be just crap days. It's going to feel like, and you're like, man, the weight of the world's on me. I'm in the hospital right now, Paul. You don't get it. And, well, God's in the hospital.
Yep.
God's in the hospital with you. You're not going through this alone. Just like, and I've said this before, just like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego had to go through a fire in order for Nebuchadnezzar to finally say, that's the God. That's the God we need to serve.
Yep.
In order for that to happen, they had to go into a fire. But you know what? There were four people in the fire.
Yep.
It wasn't just them three. So if you're in a hospital right now, man, God's with you. He is specifically with you right now. So call on Jesus' name. We love you guys so, 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 so much.
Boom.
We do. Tune in tomorrow. Going to be another great show.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Come on, somebody.
Peace.
That dude right there. Oh, they're getting fired up. All right, guys. We love you. See you later. Have an awesome and amazing, blessed day.
Peace, love, and grace.
Love you guys.
See ya.
Bye.